Good evening. Now the Midlands News. A former council worker has been awarded record compensation for stress suffered while doing his job. Randy Ingram used to work as a warden at Travellers Sites in Worcestershire, where he was subjected to physical and verbal abuse. Compensation of more than £200,000 was agreed because Hereford and Worcester County Council had failed to give him the support he needed. His union believes that although his case is an extreme example, it's the tip of an iceberg.
£200,000 richer, but Randy Ingram is a man broken by stress, according to his union. Once an articulate and lively council liaison worker, he's now lost all confidence after suffering a total nervous breakdown. Himself a former traveller, he used to work as a warden at council travellers' sites, but his bosses failed to give him the backing and authority to enforce site rules, which led to him being physically and verbally abused by a minority of residents. Once he was even shot at. At a news conference this afternoon, the strain was all too evident.
His confidence has been completely shattered by the whole experience, and it'll take a very, very long time for him ever to recover even part of the health I suspect that he once enjoyed.
Asked how he intended to spend his compensation, Mr. Ingram said he had no plans as yet. He said his only aim was to rebuild his health and his life. Andy Newman, BBC Midlands Today, Birmingham.
Security guards are to be recruited to patrol a Midland cemetery after vandals smashed up more than 100 graves. The headstones were knocked over and broken in two separate attacks at Bromsgrove Cemetery. The vandals also damaged flowers on a freshly dug grave. The same cemetery was the target of a similar attack last summer.
It seems the more ornate and costly the headstone, the more likely it has been smashed. This morning, Alison Smith, with her daughter Louie, visited the gravestone of her husband Joby, who was buried in the cemetery 22 years ago.
There's a heart that's been tipped over. The curb that holds the heart has been broken in two. There's two angels broken. The cherubs are broken. And it isn't only the value of the things or the upset of seeing them broken. It's the hurt that it does to think there's people like this.
Stonemasons estimate the damage will cost at least £100,000 to repair.
I realise all the work that's gone into it, carving them originally, and, you know, you can imagine how the families are feeling.
It's the second time in 6 months that Bromsgrove Cemetery has been targeted. More than 100 graves were also desecrated last summer.
A mother from Birmingham is trying to raise thousands of pounds to hire a private detective in the hope of being reunited with her son. The three-year-old boy was snatched by his father in Greece. Caroline Taylor had been awarded custody of the little boy by a Greek court last October. But after their marriage broke up, her husband abducted the child and went into hiding. That's the news from the Midlands for today. Back with more tomorrow. It's the National Weather Forecast next. From everybody here, bye-bye.
Hello, good evening. Now, most of us have been used to cold, frosty weather just like this over the last few days. But for the next few days, we're going to find more cloud and some rain too. Now, we started to see that today. This wall of cloud moving down from the northwest brought an inch of rain to the Isle of Skye. Now, it's cleared away from Scotland and Northern Ireland now, but the rain is ploughing its way southwards across England and Wales. The cloud producing some rain, you can see it is really quite patchy away from some of these western hills. And we still have some showers across western parts of Scotland. They'll be there through this evening and overnight. The cloud and rain elsewhere slipping its way slowly southwards. Eventually the cloud will thicken in the southeast, but before then we could well find temperatures very close to freezing, but certainly not as cold as it was last night. To the north, behind this cloud and rain, some broken cloud, and so temperatures again will be close to freezing, particularly across eastern parts of Scotland, where there could well be a few icy patches. Now tomorrow then, a lot of cloud for England and Wales, nothing like as sunny as it was this morning. Some rain and drizzle too. Now the rain is going to push its way northward, soon turning wet across Northern Ireland, some heavy rain too for northwestern parts of England, southern Scotland, the wind picking up, some gusty southwesterly winds. And also across northern parts of Scotland, the showers will turn heavier and more frequent. But at the other end of the country, southern parts of England should become dry and brighter. Not too much sunshine, but at least it's going to be a good deal milder than today. Temperatures in double figures in those southwesterly winds. Now, it's this weather front that's bringing the cloud and rain. It's going to wriggle around central areas for the next few days. Eventually, it starts to push its way southwards as high moves into the north. So for a time, we're going to have some cold northerly winds. Still mild though across England and Wales as we head towards Wednesday. Still some rain too. That rain pushing its way slowly southwards. Colder weather in Scotland and Northern Ireland with some wintry showers. Bye bye for now.
Abandoned as a baby, his face destroyed by disease. Adopted by a doctor who rebuilt his life. His experience captivated the world for nearly 20 years.
You're one of our family.
Desmond Wilcox returns to the extraordinary story of the boy David.
He wants to go back to Peru to find the people who rescued him from almost certain death.
Thank you very much.
But is he ready to meet his natural family? Only David can decide. Wednesday at 9:30 on BBC One.
How will they fare against South Melbourne? Manchester United's next game is tomorrow, live on BBC One at 8 o'clock.
What does it take to be cast away?
I don't think ethics come into it. It's survival of the fittest.
Why would you do it?
Stop the world. I want to get off.
It'll certainly improve me as a person.
This is my chance, and if I don't do it now, I never will.
What would you miss?
My duvet.
My cat.
My mum.
The biggest social experiment ever.
I was going to leave yesterday.
Castaway 2000, a new community for a new millennium. Tuesday the 18th of January on BBC One.
Sci-fi adventure in a desperate world of the future, but it's not all bad. Sylvester Stallone is Judge Dredd on BBC One in half an hour. Preparing for possible frontline action now on BBC One, a new series of Soldiers to Be. It's a tough course, well matched by the strong language.